I've been bikeless for about 2 weeks, and I've been shopping around for great bang for your buck fixed gear bikes, because even your friendly neighborhood fixed gear YouTuber can't exactly just max out his credit card willy-nilly on shiny bikes. I remember when I was just a wee beginner shopping for my first fixed gear, and it took me 2 solid weeks of browsing through unhelpful, sarcastic comments on bike forums before finally settling on a bike that was okay. But we don't want just an okay bike, we want a great bike. Because you should never settle for anything, not even on your bike. Needless to say, I wasted about 20 hours of my life trying to find an answer to a question that should have taken about 10 minutes. I wasted my time, so you don't have to. Here is how to spot great beginner fixed gear bikes. Here is an easy to follow checklist so you can tell if any entry level bike is worth your money. Off-the-shelf beginner bikes, your money will be best spent in the $400 to $500 price range. This sounds like a lot of money, especially if you're not sure whether you'll even like to ride your bike, but here's why it's a good idea to spend a little bit more. Bikes in the $400 to $500 price range will be great out of the box and require very little upgrades, if any. This price range hits the sweet spot for the affordability to quality ratio. If you spend less, you'll likely get a significantly crappier bike, and if you spend more, you'll really experience diminishing returns. A $400 to $500 bike will have durable components that can withstand daily abuse, and it will perform well enough. If you're a beginner, well enough to me means amazingly to you. Even if you end up not liking your bike, people know that the bikes in this price range tend to be really good deals and will jump at the opportunity to buy a used one. Overall, these bikes are a pretty low risk investment, and you can easily sell it to get most of your money back. But because these bikes are such great buys, you're probably going to love it and not have to worry about selling it. So here's how to tell whether a beginner bike is worth your money. The first item on the checklist is to see whether the company has a geometry chart and components list posted for the bike, because these two documents are absolutely crucial for seeing whether a bike is worth your money. If a bike that you're looking at is either missing a geometry chart or a components list, or worse, both, just skip it. It will not be worth your money. Every great beginner fixture will be upfront about what you are buying, down to every last component and every last millimeter. With that said, not every bike with a components list and a geo chart is a good choice. So here is what to look for in the details. Look for double butted 4130 chromoly steel or double butted 6061 aluminum. At this point, all you really need to know is that double butted means that the bike will be lighter and ride more nicely. I recommend getting a steel bike in this price range because they'll usually weigh about the same or even lighter than an aluminum framed counterpart, meaning you can get the higher durability and smoother ride quality of steel without the weight penalty that is normally associated with steel bikes. So steel at this price range is a win-win in my book. Aluminum will have a stiffer and harsher ride quality, which will be less comfortable for street use. Most people that get beginner aluminum frames choose them because they think they look cool. If you like the looks of aluminum frames enough to sacrifice ride quality, then by all means, if that helps you ride your bike more, then get one. But for most people's first bike, I'd highly recommend steel. Again, look for double-butted 4130 chromoly, which is sometimes called Reynolds 520 or some other made-up type of chromoly, but they're all the same. And look for double-butted 6061 aluminum. The next thing to keep an eye out for is the wheel set. Stick to rims that are 30 millimeters deep or less. This keeps the bike durable while still having a nicer ride quality. Avoid those super flashy, deep, colorful rims that cater to beginners that don't know any better, because I've ridden them, and yes, they do in fact suck. Also, keep an eye out for seal bearing Novatec or Formula hubs. These hubs are maintenance free and will spin smoothly nearly forever. My pair of seal bearing Formula hubs are nearly 5 years old, and they spin just as smoothly as the day that I got them. So yeah, they are kind of the bee's knees. You can recognize seal bearing Formula hubs based on their trapezoidal pattern that goes around the axle, and you can spot seal bearing Novatec hubs based on their teardrop shape that goes around the axle. A lot of companies rebrand these hubs, so it's really important to identify these hubs based on their appearance, because the specs list might not exactly say Novatec or Formula hubs, but trust me, they are the same hubs if they look like that. The rims will either be brandless, the company's own in-house brand, or branded Alex or Weinemann. Generally, the brandless wheels will be heavier and less durable. The in-house branded ones can be hit or miss, and the Alex and Weinemann branded rims will be good enough and have the most consistent quality. Alex and Weinemann make decent entry-level wheel sets, and the general consensus is that they're fine. they're fine. They're not the lightest, they're not the prettiest, but they'll get you from point A to point B without any surprises. After the frame and the wheels, there are some other marks of quality that you should keep an eye out for. Generally, bikes that are made in Taiwan will be nicer than bikes that are made in China. Most mid to high-end bikes and components are made in Taiwan, so if you can get an entry-level fix gear that's made here, then great. When you come to a fork in the road, pick it up to make sure it's a good one. Great steel beginner fixed gear bikes will come with a lugged fork. Bikes that come with a unicrown fork can also be a good buy, but a lugged fork is a mark of a high quality bike. If you're getting an aluminum bike, make sure it comes with a carbon fork, because again, a carbon fork on an aluminum bike is a mark of a high quality bike. And it'll make the bike lighter, which is nice too. Other marks of craftsmanship and attention to detail will be in the welds. If you're looking at a steel bike, check to see if the welds are consistent and tidy. If you're looking at an aluminum bike, make sure the welds are polished and smooth, because the quality of the welds is often a telltale sign of the amount of quality control that goes into each bike. Tektro brakes and levers will be the best that you can get at this price. They're affordable brakes with great stopping power, great feel, and they don't weigh a ton, so they're really a win-win-win. And lastly, keep an eye out on the finishes of the components, like the cranks, the stem, the handlebars, and the seat post. The smoother and more consistent and the prettier that the finishes are on these components can key you in into the bike's overall quality. That is how to spot great beginner fixed gear bikes. First, make sure that the frame set is either double butted 4130 chromoly or double butted 6061 aluminum. Two, check for seal bearing Novatec or Formula hubs. And three, look for the marks of craftsmanship. You can download the great beginner fixed gear checklist in the description. And if you'd like my personal help with your bike purchasing process, consider becoming a super subscriber by supporting me on Patreon. And if you want my no-brainer recommendations for your first fixed gear bike, hit that subscribe button, because I'll tell you exactly which bikes are great in the next video. And if you've already ridden your bike today, why don't you reward yourself by watching another video? If you haven't ridden your bike yet, stop watching me right now, close down your device, hop on your bike, and have a good time. If you're watching this video because you don't have a bike yet, go for a run or something, or a hike, or just get out there, do something. Regardless, remember to stay reasonably dangerous.